Hey, my name is Gala, and today I would like to review one of my Google Data Studio templates that works well for websites with blogs. This template includes also some basic data about Google and Facebook ads, but generally speaking, it works well for blog website, for content websites. Which data sources do we have here? I will go chart by chart through report and we'll do some comments about data sources. So we start from Google Analytics conversions month by month. And how we can see from the title, it is a Google Analytics data, and I used Direct Connector to Google Data Studio, which is default Google Analytics connector. On the first chart, we see our goals split it by month. It is good to see when you work with content websites and you don't see some daily basis dynamic well. And for you, it's more interesting to see like long-term distance for to understand how your website perform. And here we have goal one, goal two, goal three, and goal four. In your cases, of course, it will be something like real goals, like contact us, download something, I don't know, requests additional info, etc., etc. So we have our goals month by month for last year. Then we have a table with the same goals, but only last month data, as you can see from the note, and split it by channel grouping. So we can see that mostly all our goals came here from direct traffic. So this is Google Analytics demo account, so it is random data. Then if we scroll down a bit, we can see these conversions by channels. Again, we have the same conversions, but we would like to take a look a bit deeper on them. For example, we have charts for each conversions, which conversion, and we have like the big number and compare the big numbers that represent the last month comparison with the previous period. So, for example, today is August, so this will be July data, and this comparison with June. And also, we have some charts with 12-month data that we can see this goal, how this goal works in dynamic. Also, we have traffic source filter, and we can select on the display, for example, and check how many goals. Okay, almost nothing, but it's fine. So we can select any traffic sources that we are interested in. Let's scroll down. Here a bit of understanding who our visitors are, and for content website, it is really nice to see how many new and returning visitors we attract. Because if it is content website, we are interested in users come to our website again and again. So it is really nice to see the percentage of new and returning visitors. And here we have again 12 months. Then that is it actually. Then one more table on this page. It is a Google Ads split by campaign last month data. I do not show you here like deep analytics of Google Ads. We just need to like super fast overview of what is going on in our Google Ads account. And here we have Google Ads data source. It is a direct connector to Google Data Studio as well. It is default connector that you can use for free. And here we have campaign, impressions, clicks, cost per click, and all conversions. So only main key data. That is it. Just super fast. And then if we scroll down, we can see inquiries month by month. This data comes from Google Sheets, and it was my clients' custom requests. But it is really nice to see, because this way, if you can split your inquiries by channels, it is really interesting to see where from your, if okay, for example, you have some off, not online but offline, data sources from your, like, some of your clients came for you because of friends, because of some outdoor ads, etc. You can add this information to Google Sheets and pull it to Google Data Studio. And here we have grand total, and here we have also information split by month for different sources and different type of inquiries. And I really like this view, this pivot table. And go to the next page, and we can see this pivot table again. Okay, second page. Second page, it is a this page absorbs our blog. And the first table that we have here, it is a top pages from the last 12 months. Here we have pivot table again, as a previous table as well. Here we have page title, so we can see the title of our blog post, and we can see that grand total of page views for this article, and we can see how many page views we had month by month. And it is really interesting to see the dynamic here, because some posts became popular, then 1 month they become popular, other months no. And it is interesting to see how do they perform. For example, this is interesting situation, because here we have in May we had 500 page views, and in June and in April zero. It is weird. Maybe this page didn't work well in June, or maybe we hid this page, or removed it. So maybe we can take a look what is going on there. Or for example, some page became more popular. Maybe we can check it deeply and check maybe someone wrote an article and added our link to there, and maybe we'll have some referral traffic. So it's interesting analytics. And if we scroll down, we see a bit more information about our blog. We can see month, like last 9 months, and we can see top five articles from our blog for each month. So we can see how which article became more popular, and when it became more popular. So we can do some analysis of that and understand, okay, some topics are more interesting for our users, some of them not, and some of the topic is really good and performs good for a long period of time. Some of them have like has some short period of time when they popular and kind of that. So this is really nice overview. And the third page, it is the last page of our report. It is a Google Analytics traffic by channel month by month. Again, this data came from Google Analytics. Actually, I forgot to tell you. Second page, this block overview comes from default connector of Google Analytics to Google Data Studio. So it is the same connector. Here we have our traffic by channel, month by month, again, last 12 months. And we can see that most of the traffic we have from direct, and then we have some page search or display and affiliate traffic. And then, but this is a really nice overview of our traffic, but it is difficult to understand exact numbers. So I added this table where you can see information month by month, but already you can see the exact numbers, how many users did you have. And the last section of our report, it is a Facebook ads overview. Again, it is just super fast, super quick overview, We just check the main metrics. What is the most important metrics when we work with paid ads? It is a cost, clicks, conversions. But in this case, we didn't have set up conversions, so we just stay with clicks, cost per click, reach, cost per mile, and 3 second video plays. And we have this data for previous months, comparison with previous months. For example, if this number it is July, this comparison is June. Below we have some chart with information month by month to see data in dynamic. Here I used clicks, but if you have conversion set up, of course better to change it to conversions. What else is interesting for us? When we work with Facebook ads, for me it is very important which platform works better and which place works better. So we show some information about publisher platform and placement for last month and in dynamic. This data we can pull, we cannot pull this data using default free connectors, so you have to buy some third-party connectors. It could be Supermetrics or Power My Analytics, for example. In this case, we used Power My Analytics connector. It's quite nice to work with. And we just connect Facebook data using this connector to Google Data Studio without any Google BigQuery or Google Sheets or something. That is it. This is our report. Again, I would like to put your attention here on the second page because it is really nice and I don't see quite often some blogs overview, some blogs report, so it is really nice. If you I would be happy if you use it actually with your website. Okay, try it and let me know if you have some doubts, questions, or you need some advices about this report or in Google Data Studio in general. Hope you like my video. See you soon. Bye bye.